Amethyst Lunatari back with another episode of Let's Play Sentinel Worlds I and Future Magic. Now, about to start part 10 here. You may or may not have noticed when we were orbiting this planet to go get some minerals, some rocks to bring back for cash. There was this message. There's a beacon. 1151 by 769. The Federation Board says somebody is requesting assistance. They don't say who that is. By the way, here's the old song for the... So we're gonna go check this out. Ships moving across the sky. One of them's ours. As I was talking about with the red animals. We can kill them if we want to. Recharging turret. Dead. Not necessary though, they can't attack you. At least that I've seen. Dwellers talk inside the hut. Now, I'm not sure, this is even less advanced than the farmers. So, into this building. Pots, bamboo tables furnish the dwelling. And really, that's nothing else. It's just a small little hut, but there is someone here to talk to. He has quite a mirthful grin on his face here. The Warhaka leader. Was Federation assistance requested here? Yes, beasts from the ground dig in our fields. Beasts? What do you mean? Aha. Read paragraph 49. Only had to read a couple of these so far. There's a lot more. There's a lot of story to this game once you get to it. Alright, the beasts just were there one morning, the slender Warhakan explains. We did not see them come by, or by what means they arrived in our domain. Now we are being invaded. They are fearsome creatures, much taller than one of the people, and with a reptilian cast to their features. They seem capable of devouring one of us without having to resort to any weapons. We have seen them uproot trees with little effort. When one of our people tried to hail them from afar, she was ignored. None dare approach them closely for fear of the possible consequences. When your people first came to this world, you said you would aid in settling any disputes that might arise between our races. Now we ask for your aid in helping us stop this unwarranted invasion of our homes. One final word of caution. Remember, the next 49 is 53. I don't know what that means. This is paragraph 49, but I took a peek at 53 and it doesn't have anything to do. It talks about Graper, so I don't know. So, sorry, you gave me drinking, I'm sure. We're unaware of another race besides you and the tower dwellers. You have to live here to know. Can you help us? Tell us where to find them, and we'll see what can be done. 62. The beasts may be found towards the setting sun. Beyond the sky pillars of emptiness where your vessels dock. Here, let me show you on this drawing where they reside. He's talking about the towers. Three towers of Kaldor. A comparison of the crude Warhakian map and Federation chart shows the approximate location of the invasion to be Kaldor 1012, 622. All lines of topic, and that's basically it. Starts over. So, we're left to carry on our business at this point. Come backside. Best way to go is orbit. Pardon me. So. X-1012. Here we are. Hills are seen in the distance. There's gorillas here. I've seen those before. Now, somewhere around here is this cave. Now, obviously, it's going to be 1012 something by 622 something. If we stray too far, we'll be able to see. It's funny how it just ends like this. Do-do-do. So, oh, mountain snake. For EGA graphics, I have to say that the art in this drawings, or illustrate graphics, whatever you want to call them. Very good. Wait, wait, what's that? Aha! There's a bunch of ore here, so might as well pick that stuff up. A cave entrance in the rock. Enter new area. Now, you're gonna see us fight in combat for the first time. And that was easy. Let's see. Equip weapons. She has her energy blade equipped. I'm just going to look at a profile. He's got a shotgun. Ripley's got her shotgun. She's got her auto pistol. And Arnold has his shotgun. All equipped, so we should be good, and they have backup melee weapons in case they run out of ammo. What are these? These are cave bears. Now, the way this combat works is you only control your main character by enter when the weapon is ready, and space to target. I slice for 20 damage. Kind of a hassle. It should auto-target whoever's nearest, but anytime you kill something and there's a whole bunch of them, you have to hit space to target again. Unusual footprints along the ground. Terminator says, give me a target. Dust swirls in the center of the room. So you hit L to see your map, which of course will scroll off the screen, but we can check out these rooms. It's obviously going to go up. Steel beams hold up the crumbling tunnel. So, just looking around here. I'm hitting every space because you go over one space, it's easy to miss something. You can't see what the item is until you've walked right on top of it. Let's do some damage in here. Well, I don't see anything to damage. Oh, well, there's something. Blood splatters everywhere. Yeah. So, oh, we didn't find anything here. So, we're gonna go off the map. Just about. Now it's scrolled over to the next section of map, as you can see. Well, there's only one way to go from here. What could be the unusual footprints, I wonder? Not bear? Possibly something else. Steady stream of water leaks from the top. Yeah, Terminator. You want to do damage, but there's nothing but a stream of water. Lionel says, I don't think I was trained for this. Well, you are a singer. Pop singer. Sometimes when I start swiveling, it won't stop. See, they keep on coming. These are really just random encounters. As they're not all in the fight because two of them are ducked down that corridor. That's the problem with this, is you have to manipulate your crew members into getting into the area you want to get them. You want them to be in. And they don't always follow suit. See a whole bunch of friendlies. Through that area. And apparently nothing here. If this stops swiveling around. Probably holding down the key a bit too long. Pardon me, and let's see, oh yeah, you were trained for this, don't worry about it. Okay. I'm getting a little seasick here. Now, what is this? Oops, Ripley, I think they found you. Kushal Guard, which looks a lot like the alien in Aliens. And they're all over the place. Stone rooms are singing along the passage. You can talk to them. We are friendly. Who are you? Dig, dig, dig. Right. That's it.